Dear students, our next topic is heat engine. Heat engine is a device by which a system is made to undergo a cyclic process that results in conversion of heat to work. So this heat engine converts heat energy into work energy. So we know whether it is a bike or bus or train. For example, suppose it is a bike or car, it uses petrol as a fuel. Similarly, if you take a bus, it makes use of diesel as an engine, and there the fuel undergoes combustion. And when it undergoes combustion, heat energy is produced, and that heat energy is converted into work by the heat engine. But during conversion of heat to work, there is a cycle of several processes. Now, after knowing the cycle of several processes, let us come to this topic. To prepare a heat engine with maximum efficiency, a French engineer named Carnot Soddy suggested 4 processes: isothermal expansion, adiabatic expansion, isothermal compression, and adiabatic compression. After the 4 processes, the system reaches its initial state. So this is one cycle, and this is cyclic process, because the system started from A, it moved from A to B because of isothermal expansion, B to C because of adiabatic expansion, C to D because of isothermal compression, and D to A because of adiabatic compression. So our system came to its initial state after completing the 4 processes. Therefore, this is cyclic process, or a cycle of 4 processes. Now let us consider each process in detail. Afterwards, let us summarize the 4 processes. Now first, A to B. So first we are starting with the, so our system is at A, that is in this state. See, what are its thermodynamic variables? Pressure, volume, temperature. Since it is its initial state, we given the values P1, V1, T1. We have taken an ideal gas with volume V1, and this is attached to a hot reservoir at a temperature T1, and the T1 temperature is 120 degrees centigrade. At this temperature, the gas absorbs some heat energy. After absorbing Q1 heat energy, it expands, that is called thermal expansion. See, this is isothermal process, no? So the walls of the cylinder conduct heat, therefore it could absorb Q1 heat energy. After absorbing the heat energy at this temperature, it has expanded. This is called as thermal expansion, and its volume increased from V1 to V2. So here, let me show here, if volume increases, pressure also changes. So pressure changes from P1 to P2. volume changes from V1 to V2, but temperature doesn't change because this is isothermal process. Temperature will be same. Here also 120 degree centigrade. Since there is no change of temperature, its internal energy doesn't change. Internal energy doesn't change means change in internal energy is zero. Let me write the first law of thermodynamics. Let me write here. In isothermal process, delta U is equal to zero. Therefore, here delta Q means heat absorbed. How much energy, heat energy is absorbed? Q1. So this is zero. So some work is done. And in isothermal process, how much work is done? We derived expression for work done. We derived this expression. And in isothermal process, since delta U is zero, since this is zero, the heat absorbed is completely converted into work. That is why heat absorbed is Q1 and work done is this much. Since work is done by the system, this is positive. Now let us consider B2C. Now what is happening? Adiabatic expansion. It means no exchange of heat energy between system and surroundings. So let me write the first law of thermodynamics. There is no exchange of heat energy means delta Q zero. Now delta U is equal to minus delta W. Here the expansion is by the gas only. Here the gas itself is expanding and pushing the piston to right hand side. Therefore the work is done by the gas, by the system. Therefore here also the work done is positive. Minus into plus, minus. Here change in internal energy is becoming negative. Delta U is negative. It means what? Its internal energy is decreasing. If internal energy decreases, its temperature also decreases. So now by adiabatic expansion its temperature is decreasing. See here it is 120. Now the temperature becomes say 80 degree centigrade. So this is T2. So let me write here the coordinates of C. Here since volume increased, I write V3. Here it was V2, now it is V3. Since volume increased, pressure also changes. It was P2 here. Now it will be P3. And temperature changed from 120 to 80. Here T1. Now here it is T2. Next process from C to D. From C to D means there is decrease of volume. So that is isothermal compression. C to D is isothermal compression. Means what? You are pushing the piston into the cylinder. Isothermally. Isothermal means temperature should not change. Here it is 80 degree centigrade, means here also 80 degree centigrade. Without changing temperature, its volume is decreased. Its volume is decreased from V3 to V4. See here V4. Since volume changed, pressure also changes. P4. But temperature same, T2 only. Now, since this is, let me write the first law of thermodynamics. In isothermal process, there is temperature is constant. Temperature constant means the internal energy also constant. Internal energy constant, so delta U 0. So this suggests what? Delta Q is equal to delta W. Delta Q is equal to delta W. Now, work is done on the system by us. Therefore, work done is, according to sign convention, work done is negative. So, if work done is negative, then delta Q becoming negative. Delta Q is negative. Delta Q negative means what here? According to sign convention, when the system absorbs the heat energy, that is positive. And heat energy is rejected by the system, that is negative. So here delta Q is negative. It means what? Heat energy is rejected by the system in isothermal compression. So heat energy is rejected. How much heat energy is rejected? Say Q2 heat energy is rejected. So Q2 heat is rejected by the system to surroundings. Q2 heat is rejected. In isothermal compression, Q2 heat is rejected to the surroundings. So this is Q2. Now is equal to work done. How much work is done by us? For that, we have derived expression work done in isothermal process. Work done in isothermal process. It should be in this model only, but with some changes. Mu r, see here it was at temperature T1. Now it is at temperature T2. It was at 120 degree centigrade. Now it is at 80 degree centigrade. That is a T2 temperature. So I should write here, instead of T1, I should write T2. and log. See, this is initial volume, this is final volume here. It expanded from V1 to V2. But now, it compressed from V3 to V4. It compressed from V3 to V4. This is initial volume, this is final volume. I should write in the denominator initial volume. So here initial volume is V3. And final volume is V4. And from this equation we understand that whatever work is done on the gas, the work done is equal to heat rejected. Next process, from D2A, from D2A, and this is adiabatic compression. Now there is no exchange of heat energy. Let me write here, first law of thermodynamics. In adiabatic process, there is no exchange of heat energy. This is zero. And now I should write delta U is equal to minus delta W. But here, work is done on the system. Therefore, work done is negative. So, minus into minus plus. Delta U is positive. Delta U positive means what? Its internal energy increased. If its internal energy increases, its temperature also increases. Its temperature also increases. Now it is at a temperature of 80. Now that becomes 120 degree centigrade. That is T1. So it reaches the original state. And here we should write the work done. We derived expression for work done in adiabatic process, and that was mu r T1 minus T2 by gamma minus 1. Now here also minus into minus plus. Mu r T1 minus T2 by gamma minus 1. We have completed the four processes. Now let us summarize. Now let us fill up the table. A to B is isothermal expansion. In isothermal expansion, since it is isothermal process, the change in internal energy is zero. Heat absorbed is Q1. Work done is V2 by V1. Now, from B to C is adiabatic expansion. In adiabatic expansion, the change in internal energy is minus delta W, and the work done is gamma minus 1, and there is no exchange of heat energy in adiabatic process. C to D, isothermal compression. In isothermal compression, since it is isothermal process, delta U 0. delta Q. Q to amount of heat is rejected to the surroundings and work done is V4 by V3. But here D2A, it is adiabatic compression. Since it is adiabatic process, there is no exchange of heat energy in adiabatic process. And the change in internal energy is equal to plus delta Q, delta W. And the work done is mu R T1 minus T2 by gamma minus 1. Now let us consolidate the four processes, because now we have completed one cycle. So in a cycle of four processes, say this is a famous Carnot cycle. I should write here Carnot. In a Carnot cycle of four processes, so what is the net change in internal energy? Let me write here. Net change in internal energy. Net change in internal energy. See here, plus delta Q minus delta Q gets cancelled. So these are zero. So zero. See, already we learned in the previous video, in a cyclic process, net change in internal energy is zero. Because it came to its original state, its initial state, therefore it will regain its initial state. Suppose with U1 internal energy it has started, again it came back to its initial state. So it will reach its initial internal energy U1. So U1 minus U1, zero. So there is no change. In a cyclic process, internal energy of a system doesn't change. Okay. Now next. What about heat energy? It has absorbed Q1 amount of heat energy at T1 from the hot reservoir. Let me write here. It has absorbed Q1 heat from hot reservoir at higher temperature T1. Okay. Third, about Q2 also let me write a sentence. It has rejected Q2 heat to surroundings. At lower temperature T2, that is 80 degree centigrade. Fourth one. Here heat is absorbed by the system, therefore this is positive according to sign convention. Here heat is rejected to the surroundings, therefore according to sign convention this is negative. Then to do work, how much heat is utilized? Total Q1 heat is not utilized to do work, because this much heat is rejected to the surroundings. So how much heat is utilized to do work? Q1 minus Q2. To do work, Q1 minus Q2 heat is utilized. And how much work is done? See, here this and this gets cancelled. So we are left with only these two. So work done in a cycle of processes is equal to mu r t1 v2 by v1 plus mu r t2 v4 by v3. And you know already that isothermal process obeys Boyle's law, that is PV is equal to constant, and adiabatic process obeys PV power gamma is equal to constant. We used these while deriving expressions for work done by the isothermal process and adiabatic process. Now let us make use of these once again. See, from A to B it is isothermal expansion, so it obeys Boyle's law. It obeys Boyle's law means PV is equal to constant. So it means P1V1 is equal to P2V2. So I can write for the process A to B, what I can write? P1V1 is equal to P2V2. This is one equation I got for first process. Now next to B to C, this is adiabatic expansion, and adiabatic process obeys this equation. So let me write here PV, here P2 V2 power gamma from B to C, P2 V2 power gamma is equal to here P3 V3, P3 V3 power gamma. Next C to D, this is isothermal compression, so it obeys Boyle's law. So P3 V3 is equal to P4 V4. Next D to A, D to A is adiabatic compression. Adiabatic process obeys P power gamma is equal to constant. So here P4 V4 gamma is equal to P1 V1 power gamma. This is fourth equation. Multiplying the four equations, multiplying the four equations, so multiply 1 into 2 into 3 into 4, multiplying the all the four equations. See LHS, P1 V1 into P2 V2 power gamma, P3 V3 into P4 V4 power gamma is equal to right side P2 V2 into P3 V3 gamma, P4 V4 into P1 V1 power gamma. So simplifying this, we get V4 by V3 is equal to V1 by V2. Now let us substitute this value here. So here first term as it is, second term in place of V4 by V3 we can write V1 by V2. Here mu r t1 log v2 by v1, if you see the v1 is numerator and v2 is denominator, If you reverse this, instead of V1 by V2, if you write V2 by V1, then here minus comes. So that we can change, we can take common, what comes common, mu r T1 minus T2 log V2 by V1. So this is the network done in the cycle of 4 processes.